Welcome back. So we'll continue with the positive edge trigger with the asynchronous inputs now. So in the previous case, we saw the positive edge trigger D flip-flop without asynchronous inputs. And now along with that, we'll see the meaning. Along with the asynchronous inputs, we'll see how the positive edge trigger D flip-flop is analyzed. Okay. So the asynchronous inputs we had seen, the preset and clear inputs. So these are exclusive to each other. Okay. So both can be enabled simultaneously. They can be disabled simultaneously, but they cannot be enabled. Meaning, when PR is enabled, clear has to be disabled, or when preset is disabled, clear has to be enabled. This is what I mean by. Okay. So can they be both 00? Yes. 00 means disabling, right? So that's why. So they can be both disabled simultaneously, but make sure they can't be enabled simultaneously. Okay. So for the our analysis, okay, case one, okay. So what we'll try to do is we'll let PR to be 1. Okay. So PR to be 1 and clear to be 0. Meaning I am enabling the preset input and I am disabling my clear input. Okay. But here you can see this particular logic diagram is similar to the positive edge trigger D flip-flop, but the only thing is, okay, flip-flop 1, 2, 4, 5 and 6, they have got additional input. Okay. So instead of 2 inputs, now they have become 3 inputs. Meaning the NAND gate 1 is getting the preset along with NAND gate 5. So NAND gate 2 is getting clear along with NAND gate 4 and NAND gate 6. Okay, so this is what the changes that have been done now. Okay, so we'll try to see what really happens with respect to this preset and clear. Now when preset is 1, you can see that the preset bar is the input that is going in. Okay, so preset is 1 means preset bar is 0. The same preset is going for the NAND input, one of the input of the fifth NAND gate. Clear is 1, okay, and the same clear is going here, and the same clear 1 is coming over here. Simple. Output of NAND gate is 1 is 1 because one of the input is 0. I at least worry what is the other thing, right? And this one is going as one of the input to this. Now again, the output of NAND gate 5, one of the input of NAND gate 5 is 0. So I can simply say Q is 1. Yes, I at least worry what is this now. Then I will let this output of fifth NAND gate as coming as an input to the sixth NAND gate. Okay, output of the fifth NAND gate is acting as one of the input of the sixth NAND gate. Okay, now. So now in order to analyze Q bar, we should know what exactly this. Okay. Now to do this, and I said, whenever any one of this asynchronous inputs are enabled, we least bother what is C, that is whether it is 0 or 1, and we least bother what is my D. Okay. I want my output to be set and I want out complement to be 0. Okay, that's what we'll try to see. Now what I'll try to do is, in order to analyze this and to get the Q bar, okay, I will let C to be 0, that's it. C is 0, one of the input of NAND gate 2 is 0, one of the input of NAND gate 3 is 0, okay. This clock is coming only for these two, okay. So now I can predict the output of NAND gate 2, that is 1, and output of NAND gate 3 as 1. Okay. Any of the output of fifth NAND gate doesn't change because one of the input is 0. Now we got the output of NAND gate 3 as 1. Okay. So now we got all the inputs of NAND gate 6, 1, 1, 1, output is 0. This we are getting when C is equal to 0. Now what I'll try to do, I'll change, taking instead of C 0, I'll take it as 1 now. So num means instead of 0, I'll consider 1. So this becomes 1 and this becomes 1 now. Now 1 1 1, what is the output? 0, and the same output of NAND gate 2 is acting as one of the input of NAND gate 3. One of the input of NAND gate 3 means this is still 1. So there is no change in happening in this 3. So 1, 1, 1, still it is 0. So irrespective of C, okay, whether it is 0 or 1, the moment I make PR to be 1 and clear to be 0, my output is set. That's what we are saying. When PR is 1 means its complement is 0. When clear is 0 means its complement. This is active low. These are active low signals. These two, since it is a complement input we are giving, we call this as something like active low signal. Active low. Meaning when they are 0, they are enabled. When they are 1, they are disabled. Active low signal. These are active low signal. This is what we are. Is this clear? Simple. When preset enabled, clear disabled, my output will be set. This is what the first case. Similarly, I'll go with the second. Okay. Preset is 1. This is 1. Clear is 0. This is 0. This is 0. Yeah. This output 0 means input of the NAND gate 4 is 0 means this is 1. This goes here. Okay. One of the input of this NAND gate is 0 means this will be 1. Is that okay? This is 1. This is still 0. Okay. And I know that one of the input of this NAND gate 2 will be always 0 because clear bar is 0. This will never change. This is 1. I know 1, 1, 1. I should know what is this now. Right? So I got this as 1. And this as 1. Okay. This is 1. And this is 1. Okay. So preset is 1. This output is 1. And this output is 1. Then 1, 1, 1. This is 0. So this will also won't change for me. This 0. 0, 0, 1. So this is 1, 1. So right now I can't say what is this. So again, when preset is 1 and clear is 0, that means preset disabled, clear 1, I want Q to be 0 and Q bar to be 1. Again I say, irrespective of C as well as irrespective of D. Now we'll try to assume what happens if C is equal to 0. When C is equal to 0, there is no change in the output of this. But the same 0 comes over here, there is a change in the output. 1, 0, 1, this will be 0 for me. When this is 0, this is absolutely 1. When this is 1, 1, 1, 1, this is 0. Yes. Now, instead of 0, if I assume 1, what will happen now? This is 1. This won't change. This is 1. 1, 1, 1. This is 0. Yes, this is what really happening. This is 0 means this is still 1. The same 1 goes here. This is 0. So again, when I say irrespective of C is equal to 0 or 1, okay, the moment I disable preset and when I enable my clear, my output is reset. That's it. Yes. Now, I can't enable both the preset and clear by giving 1, 1, or preset bar and clear by giving 1. And this is an invalid for me. Okay, this should not do. Yes. And all these 1, 1 means they are disabled. Preset bar and clear bar 1, 1 means preset and clear are 0, 0. The moment they are clear, they are not enabled, this will simply act as a positive edge triggered D flip-flop. That's the meaning. Yes. This is what really happens now. Yes. So previously this was a 0, this was 1, and then now from 1 it is becoming something like a 0 something. Okay. So simple. We are disabling the preset, applying 1, and enabling the clear by 0. So NAND gate 2 goes to 1 as well as NAND gate 4 goes to 1. this one is now going as year as well as year. Yes. And we know that AND gate 2 is 1. 1, 1, 1. This is 0. This is 0. Yes. So, in order to see Q and Q bar, I said irrespective of C and D. So, first I let C is equal to 0. The moment I let C is equal to 0 means, okay, this is 1, whereas this will be 0. And this is 1. 1, 1, 1, all 0. And when I make this 1, again there won't be change. This will be 0. So, alternate of this will be 0 or 1. That's why this will be 1. So, when preset enabled, clear disabled, output is set. When preset disabled, out clear is enabled, output is reset. I can't enable both simultaneously. When I disable both preset and clear, my positive edge triggered D flip-flop with asynchronous inputs will exactly act as a positive edge triggered D flip-flop. This is the importance. And we know that preset and clear inputs are useful, okay, in order to initialize the flip-flop. Next, positive edge triggered JK flip-flop. So, we know this D flip-flop, right? Okay. So, you might wonder what exactly this particular combinational circuit is doing here, right? Okay. So, in order to know that, we should know what exactly this is all about. This is nothing but what? Output of AND gate 1 is J Q bar, and output of NAND gate 2, AND gate 2 is K bar Q. This is nothing but what? Output of OR gate is J Q bar plus K bar Q. Okay, you wonder how exactly I have done. This is D flip-flop. This is a positive edge D flip-flop. Positive edge trigger D flip-flop. And now I am converting that into a JK, positive edge trigger JK flip-flop. Okay. The only thing that we have to do now here is, we know that this is the truth table of a JK flip-flop, right? Yes. J0. So, along with JK, there are C, total 3 inputs. Okay. What we'll try to do is, we'll try to use a 3 variable K-map. This is one way of converting a positive edge trigger JK flip D flip-flop to a positive edge trigger JK flip-flop. Okay. So, JK and C. Okay. So, there are total 8 combination, right? So, J, K and C, there are 3 inputs means total 8 combination. That means 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1, 1. These are the 8 combination of J, K, C. And we know that when C is 0, my flip-flop output will be what? Previous. Okay. When C is equal to 1, then depends upon my JK. Now, I'll try to write my Q. Okay. So, what we'll try to do is, we'll try to write the Q. Okay. The output Q corresponding to JKC over here. Okay. Yes. First case, C0, JK both 0, 0. Okay. So, I want, so this will be my present statements. This will be my previous state. Is this clear? When C is equal to 1, JK 0, 0, 0 means it is previous. Again, this is 0. When C1, J0, K1 means it will be reset. 0, this is previous. 1, it is set. 0, it is previous. When it is 1, 0, 0, 1, 1 means it is complement. Again, same thing we are getting. Yes. Now we know the operation of jk with respect to c. Now what we'll do is, okay, I'll try to do this one. Yes, provided clock is equal to 1, what is provided clock is equal to 1, for different value of jk, we'll try to see what is my output. Jk 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1. I have enabled my flip-flop with C is equal to 1. That's it. Okay. When C is equal to 1, JK 0, 0, QT will be previous. I don't know what is previous. So that's why I will take the previous value also. So in order to predict the output Q, okay, that is next state or the present state for this. If this is present state, this will be my previous. Okay. So I'll take one more value of Q. 0, 0, 0, 0. Next, we'll have another four combination of JK, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1. And for this, it will be my 1. Now, we'll see what exactly this is. C is 1. When JK both 0, 0, my present state will be the previous. What is previous? It is 0. Yes. C1, JK, J is 0, K1 means output is reset. C is 1. J1 K is 0, output is set. When C is equal to 1, J, when both are 1, 1, output will be complement of previous, right? What is previous? 0, so it will be 1. Similarly, this will be 1, this will be 0, this will be 1. And since it is a complement of previous, previous is 1, means this will be 0. So now what I'll try to do, I'll try to get what is my Q plus expression is, QT expression is. Okay, what is my QT expression? So Q being at the, assuming Q to be MSB, and this is a three variable K map, because along with J and K, Q bar is also one of the, Q is also one of the input. Okay, so this is J bar K, this is JK, and this is J K bar. Okay, so for 0, 0, for minterm 0, it will be 0. For minterm 1, this will be 0. For minterm 2, it will be 1. For minterm 4, 3, it will be 1. For minterm 4, it is 1. Then it is 0. Then it is 1. Then it is 0. Yes. So this is what the K-map filling I get for this. So this is straight away. Whatever the K-map truth table is there, I am mapping into three variable K-map in order to get what is my present state or the next state equation. So I'll have two groups, one group and this is another group. With respect to this group, I get JQ bar plus, with respect to this, I get K bar Q. And this is what I mean by QT. QT is nothing but what? My next state equation for a JK flip-flop. This is the truth table for JK flip-flop when C is equal to 1, right? When clock is enabled, depending upon JK, I get the output, right? This is the truth table of JK flip-flop. From the truth table, I have just got the expression for the next state, that is QT. And what is that QT? Is JQ bar plus K bar Q, and that is what exactly you are seeing now. Okay? And now we'll try to analyze this positive. This is a positive edge triggered D flip-flop. Okay. I'm converting this positive edge triggered D flip-flop into positive edge triggered JK flip-flop just by using the next state equation. We know the next state equation QT is something like J Q bar plus K bar Q. Just now we saw how we got this. From the truth table of JK flip-flop, we got the next state equation, this. Okay. That means this requires one AND gate. This requires another AND gate. This is AND gate 1, which with respect to JQ bar. The second AND gate with respect to K bar Q. This is my K bar with the inverted input K, K bar. And these two are OR, and that's what this I'm getting. So this is I'm getting JQ bar plus K bar Q. The moment I keep applying my J and K, okay, this will be happening. So I'm converting a positive edge triggered D flip-flop to a JK. Now I can analyze this, okay. J is 1, K is 0, provided clock is 1. 1, yes, J1, again I have to make sure that what is my previous, okay, previous I'll assume Q is 0, Q bar is 1, that's it. So Q bar is coming here, Q is coming here, J is 1, Q bar is 1, 1, 1, it is 1, here 0, K bar, K is 0, K bar is 1, 1, 1, it is 1, this is 1. When D is 1, I want output to be 1, that's it. This will be 0. So when J1, K0, output is set, yes, that's what I'm doing. When J0, K1, when J, K1, J1, K0, output is set. Next. Again, I'll try to assume J is equal to 0. Sorry, Q is equal to 0, Q. I let both J and K to be 0. Clock is now I enable, clock is 1, so this flip-flop is enabled now. And this 0 goes here, and this 1 comes here. 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, D 0. When D is 0, what is my output? It is 0. This has to be 1 same. So when both JK are 0, 0, provided clock is equal to 1, output doesn't change. See, this is what? I got this, and I got this now. Now, if I want, okay, I'll just go with the other thing now. Again, I let, okay, previous to be 1, this will be 0. So, this 0 goes here. This 1 comes here. So, now I let K, J to be 0, K to be 1, the third combination of input. 0, 0, 0, 1, this is 0. Yes, 1 minute. J 0. K1, 1, it is 0. Yes, 0. So, this is 0. 0 means what? This will change. Again, when J0, K1, my output is preset. Last case, we'll see. What is that? J1, K1, right? I let Q2 be 1 and Q bar to be 0. So this will be 0, Q bar, and this will be 1. What I want? I want J to be 1. I want K to be also 1. This becomes 0. 1, 0, 0. 0, 1, 0. This is 0. What is this happening now? 0 and 1. Now for the next clock pulse also, I retain my J and K to be 1, 1. Okay. Now only the change is happening is this 0. So this is coming here, and this 1 is going here. 1, 1, this is 1. 0, 0, this is still 0. This is 1. Now this will be changing. That's what my previous is all about. Yes. So to convert a positive edge trigger D flip-flop to a positive edge trigger JK flip-flop, I need the characteristic equation. And that's what the characteristic equation output I should apply to the D input. I get this. That's it. Similarly, positive, the moment I get the JK flip-flop, I short the T, I mean J and K, I get the T. Or if not, I can make use of the similarly, the characteristic equation for a T flip-flop. I get as TQ bar, okay, I'll just write it the other side. So, I'll just write it here. It is T Q bar plus T bar, which is exclusive to, so that's what this exclusive. T positive edge triggered D flip flop converted to T. T input, exclusive T and Q gives me the T Q bar plus T Q bar. Again, you can take the truth table and you can derive what is the next state equation for this. So I can convert to any flip flop from the D flip flop. Okay, that's what. Again, same T. When C is 1, T is 0 means previous. When C is 1, T is 1 means complement. Okay, that's what. Next, that's what I said, the characteristic equation. We are just derived the characteristic equation of JK flip-flop. Okay, the same thing here given. Algebraic description of the next state table of a flip-flop. Next state table. Okay, if Q is my previous, QT will be its next state. Okay, if I know what is my previous, then depending upon the inputs, I can predict what is my the next state. That's what algebraic description of the next state table of a flip-flop. Constructing from the Karnaugh map for the QT plus 1 in terms of the present state and the input. Okay. So, here this is the K-map, three variable K-map in order to get the next state equation for SR flip-flop. Okay. We know that now. Again, we'll try to see how exactly it goes now. Okay. So, I have S and R input and I have to find out what is the next state equation. For that, I need what is my previous also, right? Provided clock is equal to 1, along with SR, Q is also there for me. So, total 8 combination, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1. I have 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1, and 1, right? This is what. Now, provided clocks 1, when S and R both 0, 0, output will follow previous. And what is this previous? This goes here, 0. Provided clock is equal to 1, S0, R1, output is reset. Provided C is equal to 1, when S is 1, R is 0, it will be 1. And when both S and R 1, 1, output is invalid for me. Yes, that's why I can't get anything here. It is unpredictable. 0, 0, previous, previous is 1 in this case, that is this. Okay. 0, 1, it is 0. 1, 0, it is 1. 1, 1, it is unpredictable. Now we can see that for 0, 0, 0, this is the cell 0, this is 0. 0, 0. 1 iPhone 0 1 0 1 iPhone, that's what. Now I can group like this. This is, that is a don't care. These four and these two. So I get what for with respect to this, it is S. With respect to these two, it will be R bar Q. Is this clear? No? This is the next state equation of. Similarly, what is the next state equation of JK? We just got JQ bar plus K bar Q. Next state equation for SR flip-flop is S plus R bar Q. D is simply D. And for T is T Q bar plus T bar Q, which is nothing but what? Exclusive. And this next state or the next state equation or the characteristic equation, the characteristic equations are also called as a next state equations. Okay. These are very important when we try to design the synchronous counter. Okay, this is very important. Yeah. So next, completing all these flip-flops, different classes of flip-flops, converting one flip-flop to another flip-flop. Okay, and then analyzing different characteristic equation of these four flip-flops, because we'll try to use only four flip-flops. The D flip-flop, the SR flip-flop, the T flip-flop and the JK flip-flop. Okay, so we got all those things, right? So now we'll go with the application of the flip-flop, and one of the important application of the flip-flop is it is in the register. Okay, this is what, this is the important thing. This is the register. This is very important. Okay, one of the application of this is important. Yeah, Registers like counters are clock sequences. So registers are nothing but what? Clocked sequential circuits. What I mean by sequential circuits? Sequential circuits are the logical circuits or the digital circuit whose output not only depends upon the present but also depends on the previous. That's what. A register is a group of flip-flops. Yes. Each flip-flop capable of storing one bit of information. An n-bit register consists of n flip-flops capable of storing n bits of information. Similarly, when I say a 4-bit register means it can store 4 bit of information. If I say 4-bit register means it can store 4 bit of information or capable of storing 4 bits of information. Besides flip-flops, a register usually contains combinational logic to perform some simple task. Along with the flip-flops, it will also contain combinational logic, or combinational logic plus these flip-flops, group of flip-flops, are used to perform some simple task. So in summary, flip-flops are used to hold information, and any group of flip-flops which hold information, we call it as registers. Combinational logic to control the state transition. Okay, so a register is a combination of combination logic as well as flip-flops. Flip-flops are used to hold information, and the combination logic is used to control the state transition. Okay. And now counters. Counter is essentially the difference between essentially a register that goes through a predetermined sequence of states. Register doesn't have a predetermined sequence of states, whereas the counter is essentially a group of flip-flops that goes through a predetermined state sequence of states. And similar to my register, my counter also will have a group of flip-flops plus the combinational logic. Uses of registers and counters. Registers are useful for storing and manipulating information. Okay. Internal registers in microprocessor to manipulate data. Whatever you see in any of the gadgets, if they call it as registers, means it is a group of flip-flops which are used to store the information, and I can manipulate the stored information. I can change the content of that. Okay. Counters are extensively used in control logic. Okay, whatever the program counter you see in microprocessor, program counter is used in the execution time, right? It will increment after every statement is executed. Okay, and that is where the counter, PC means program counter. Okay, it is having a predetermined sequence, and that's what it will do now. Okay. Then we will see how exactly register is all about, how it is constructed and operation in the next.